Okay, fellas, how much is 2 plus 2?
5!
Not bad, you're only one off. They're getting better.
Welcome to Sha-na-na. Now, many of you have written to me inquiring as to why an intellectual like myself would allow myself to be associated with such a mindless group like Sha-na-na. Now, my answer is pragmatic. I am merely following the ancient Socratic doctrine of the late great Socrates, who once advised Aristotle, take the money and run.
Greaser's Hall, Selman House, Armand Fussy, director in residence speaking. No, Sha-na-na isn't here. Can I take a message? They owe you $120 for a broken window. How's that? They were singing under your window and the glass broke? I didn't think their voices were that powerful. Oh, it wasn't their voices that broke the window? It was the people throwing rocks at them? Okay, I'll tell them.
When I became of age, my mother called me to her side. She said, son, you're growing up now. Pretty soon you'll take a bride. And then she said, just because you become a young man now, there's still some things that you don't understand now. Before you ask some girl for a hand now, keep your freedom for as long as you can now. My mama told me, you better shop around.
Oh.
you better shop around. Shop around. Uh-huh, don't let the first one get ya. Uh-huh, cause I don't wanna see you with ya. Uh-huh, before you let her hold you tight. Yeah, yeah, make sure she's alright. Uh-huh, before you let her take your head, my son. Understand, my son. Be a man, my son.
You're terrible. You give me a pain in the ears. I wish I couldn't hear you. The Concorde jet sounds better than you.
Now, hold it, lady. Hold it.
Don't stop me now. I'm on a roll. You should have lived in the dark ages. You look terrible in that light. I'm not in the habit of forgetting faces, but in your case, I'll make an exception.
Chicken-hearted, lily-livered excuses for a prime-time television show. Yay-o! Come on now, snap to it. Whoa, whoa. Gentlemen, our mission for tonight is a dangerous one. To trap and capture as our guest star, Robert Guillaume. You know, Benson from his own television series.
How are we gonna do that, Bazooka Beak? He's a big star.
Easy, Trench Mouth. We will do it by disguising ourselves as a hit TV show. Mesh.
It's an old trick, but it just might work.
Hey, you mean we're gonna play those spirited, wisecracking, irreverent, wild, and wacky young doctors of an army hospital in Korea who alternate between saving lives and bouts of kooky hijinks?
Oh, you took the words right out of my mouth, Barracks Brett. Just follow my instructions, Klinger, my boy. Or girl.
Yep, everything set, platoon puss. All the mash signs are pointing right here.
Great! Hey, Hot Lips, where's that tent I told you to bring?
I'm wearing it!
Ah! All right. Yeah. All right, Gracers, man your battle stations!
Is this the MASH set?
Well, we ain't soap.
Get it, fat little bulge belly. Hi, Mr. Guillaume, and welcome to MASH. We're all set here and ready to go.
What do you want me to do?
Why, sing, of course.
Sing? In the script, it said I was to get wounded. I was to lose my courage, get my courage back, get wounded again. I was supposed to take out my own appendix with a spoon. I was supposed to marry Klinger. Adopt a Korean family.
Yeah, but we changed the script a little. See, now all you have to do is sing this.
Sing this? You mean you've distilled the entire story into one musical number?
Hey, it's a long song.
It made me cry.
Hey, but fellas, what does song title to come have to do with the story?
What do you mean? They both have the word appendix in them.
Well, the song doesn't.
Well, if you want to split hairs.
Hey, wait a minute. You guys aren't kooky doctors. You're sha-na-na.
Goose lips sink ships. And sometimes even big stars like yous. I order yous to sing.
I'm not singing alone.
Oh, don't worry about that. My platoon here will give you his backup support.
Well, if you don't mind,
look,
just
look,
assume.
If you don't sing, you're going to be the star of our new war show, Missing in Action. You get my
drift? I read you loud and clear.
Ladies and gentlemen, a courageous performer who tonight is singing above and beyond the call of duty, Mr. Robert Guillaume. Oh, yeah.
Say you love me, I'll give you everything I own.
You're kidding.
I'm not kidding. I'll give you my car, and I'll give you my money, and we'll take a trip. It'll be just you and me kissing and hugging all day.
I don't want to go.
Why?
Because if I got your car and I got your money, who needs you?
Bye-bye, my love, goodbye.
Oh, I am so looking forward to this voyage away from my fabulous wealth, my estate, my sports cars, and my yachts. You know, I tell you, there is nothing better than a six-month cruise for a man to regain his perspective on the real values of life.
Oh, Jockingtons, that's marvelous, but won't you miss your polo ponies?
Oh, certainly not. They're in cabin 604.
Talk about luck. I finally take a vacation and I wind up on the ship of fools.
There goes my baby with someone new. She sure looks happy. I'm feeling blue. She was my baby till he stepped in. Bye-bye to romance. It might have been.
This is certainly a magnificent ship.
Yes, this vessel is the largest luxury liner afloat. There's accommodations for over 1,700 people, 3 grand ballrooms, 2 pretty good ones, swimming pools, tennis courts, you name it. And it's all mine.
I am impressed. I mean, you know, when you said you were buying a yacht, I had no idea you meant the Queen Mary.
Well, you know me. Nothing but the best. Hmm. Do you realize that I have a crew of over 300 men?
Really? It takes that many to operate the ship?
No, but it takes that many to get it off the trailer.
I'm through with romance. I'm through with love. I'm through with counting the stars above. And here's the reason that I'm so free. My love, baby, is through with me.
This is my favorite part of the voyage. Standing up here as the ship pulls out, waving goodbye to the people on the dock. Look at them all down there. They sure look small from up here.
They are small, you nut. This is Oz and they're Munchkins.
Oh. Goodbye, Dorothy!
Goodbye, Toto!
We're right!
Hello?
Hello.
What are you doing in that manhole?
I'm painting a picture.
Why are you painting in a dark sewer?
If you saw any of my pictures, you wouldn't ask.
This magic moment. Than wine, softer than a summer night. Everything I want I have the moment I held you tight. This magic moment, while your lips are close to mine, will last forever.
been a lot of complaints in the neighborhood about your unsafe activities and conduct on the street.
What do you mean?
Well, you, for instance, yesterday you were going 40 miles an hour in a 30-mile zone, you knocked down 30 garbage cans, and you ran into a busload full of old ladies.
Ah, it wasn't too bad. It could have been worse.
How could it possibly be worse?
I could have been in a car!
That's our extravaganza for tonight. First of all, I want to thank our guest, Robert Guillaume, for bringing something we otherwise wouldn't have had on our show tonight. A little class and talent. And, naturally, I want to thank all the lovely people in our audience that stayed for the entire show. Especially those of you who wasn't tied down. Before we finally depart, I would like to remind you of Murphy's Law. If anything can go wrong, it will. Which, I guess, explains how we got our own show. Good night, and grease for peace.
Good morning, my son, Super Greaser. How about some breakfast?
No, Mom. I've really got to get going.
Where are you going today? Changing the course of a mighty sewer?
No, I'm going to leap a tall garbage truck in a single bound.
Did you make the bed?
No, I didn't have time.
You're able to leap a tall garbage truck in a single bound, but you can't bend down to make a bed?
Come on, Mom. None of the other superheroes like Batman, Captain Marvel, and Superman have to make their beds.
But at least Batman helps his mother around the house. He flies up in the corners and he dusts.
Mom, I don't have time.
Faster than a speeding ticket, but doesn't have time to dust.
Mom, I'm going. The greasy whale's waiting for me.
Grease, darling, please. Before you fight for truth, justice, and the American way of grease, go out the door, not the window. It's a shame for the neighbors. Woo! Go have children.
Here they are, all greased up and ready to take their brains out. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, I was bitten by a rock and roll boogie bug when I was about 14. And ever since that day, a lot of people say he's pretty seedy, but we know he's clean. And then they tell that kid, don't you do what he did if you want to grow up. I say, if you want to stay young, do what I've done. Rock and roll as long as you can. Are you ready for 20 more years of rock and roll?
Are you ready? I'm ready.
Are you ready for 20 more years of rock and roll?
Are you ready? I'm ready.
Are you ready for 20 more years of rock and roll?
Are you ready? I'm ready.
Are you ready for 20 more years of rock and roll?
Are you ready? I'm ready.
Well, I was driven to a rock and roll frenzy every time I heard a band play live. And I tell you the truth, I don't know what I'd do if I couldn't get it, I just wouldn't survive. A rock and roll band. I say, if you want to have fun, do what I've done. Rock and roll, as long as you can. All right. I'm ready for 20 more years of rock and roll.
Are you ready? I'm ready.
Are you ready for 20 more years of rock and roll?
Are you ready? I'm ready.
Are you ready for 20 more years of rock and roll?
Are you ready? I'm ready. I'm ready.
Good evening, and welcome to Shanana. Before we start, I would like to give a short rebuttal to those various critics who have taken their time to insult us derogatorily. To those of you who say rotten, I answer phooey. To those of you who say stink, I rebut with horse feathers. I'm not finished. To those of you who say ridiculous, I respond with poo-poo. Or if they won't let me say that, hogwash. And to those of you who say terrific, marvelous, I say, thanks, Mom, I love you.
Hey, Lorraine, what's this?
That's your check, Coach.
$1 for a lousy donut? I don't believe it.
Well, there it is in black and white.
The place down the street only charges 35 cents for jelly donut.
Yeah, well, why don't you go on down the street?
Because they're all out of jelly donuts today.
Well, when we're out of them, they're only a dime. How do you like that guy? He leaves me a dollar tip and walks out without paying his check.
And welcome to the 484th First Annual Greaser's Choice Awards!
Right, Bowser! And for those of you who missed the other 483 shows, well, here's how it works.
Right, Jocko. As you know, ballots are sent out to register greasers all over the country and to our greasers in the armed forces overseas.
Right, Denny! The ballots are filled out, then sent to Battle Creek, Michigan, where they are tabulated by the accountant firm of Leopold and Loeb. The results are then told to everyone, and then sealed in a grease-proof bag and guarded over by Murray's security agency. And now, on with the show! Take it, Santini!
Thank you, Bowser! Our first category is for the best performance by a film actor in a film. May I have the envelope, please? Thank you.
Here, pass this on, will you?
Here, Bowser, you read it. I'm too nervous.
Okay. And the winner is... Richard Burton!
Accepting for Richard Burton is Lord HMS Turkey Bunky Trevor Hargrave III.
Terribly, awfully sorry he couldn't make it tonight, but his tux didn't come back from the laundromat on time, and he missed his train. But he did ask me to say to you all, Greece for peace.
Class all the way.
Well, well put. And now, it's time for the award we've all been waiting for. The Entertainer of the Year. Oh. May I have the envelope, please? And the winner is... James Darren!
Accepting for James Darren is James Darren.
Wait a minute. This is a hoax, man. Where's Richard Burton? I mean, you said there were going to be famous people here.
Hold it. We didn't say be. We said invited.
I mean, you said this was going to be the People's Choice Award. It's the Greaser's Choice Award.
Come on, James. So we told the little white lie. I mean, Greaser's Academy, People's Academy. I mean, what's the big deal?
Damn, buddy. It's all irrelevant. Why nitpick?
And as you knows, it's a tradition here at the Greaser's Choice Awards for the Entertainer of the Year to sing.
I won't sing. Don't ask me.
Now, James, one thing. It's not utterly essential that you sing.
Unless, of course, you wouldn't be adverse to having your widow accept the award in your stead.
You get his drift, James, son.
What do you want me to sing?
Like.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Greaser's Choice for Entertainer of the Year, James Darren!
She acts on a teenage just in the cool. Looks about although she's a small fry, just about so high, Gidget is the one for me. A regular tomboy dressed for a prom. Boy, how cute can one girl be? Although she's not king size, her finger is ring size, Gidget is the one for me. If she says she loves you, you can bet your boots she loves you. If she says she hates you, that can also mean she loves you. It very well may be she's just a baby, speaking romantically. If that's a bad feature, I'll be the teacher. The Gidget is the one for me. She's not much on glamour, and she should improve her grammar. Still I sigh and stammer, and my heart beats like a hammer. Strictly from Dixie, face like a pixie, shorter than girls should be. The rest of the shipment, standard equipment, just a doll in dungaree. The Gidget,
Gidget
is the one for me.
Greaser's Hall Selma House. Yes, I'm Armand Fussy, the director in residence. You say Shanana is in your house singing? Well, they've been known to do that. Where are they singing? In the shower? Is the water on? It is? Then it can't be Sha-na-na.
Down to the drugstore to be with the crowd. A can of soda pop for crying out loud. All day long, sitting on a stool. She drink a milk, a shaker, and she giggle like a fool. She's a milkshake, a mademoiselle. Milkshake, a mademoiselle. Look at her, what's she doing to me?
Hey, what's good today?
Well, now if you're talking food, our special is smorgasbord.
Oh, wow, hey, yum.
What's smorgasbord?
He doesn't eat out much, does he?
Very few places accept them. Ah.
Smorgasbord means buffet.
Buffet?
Well, now let me put this another way. Smorgasbord means a whole lot of food, and you get all the food you can eat for $1.
Oh, well, I'm hungry. I'll have $2 worth.
Well, she wanna go, steady kids are having a ball. A same old line for Peter and Paul. Come on, baby, give me a break. You can't get no kicks up from it. Ooh, a milkshake. She's a milkshake, mademoiselle. Cool as she can be. She's a milkshake, mademoiselle. Look at her, what she doing?
Hey, Samantha! Glad's the trouble! My milkshake tastes like chicken soup.
Yeah, and my chicken soup tastes like a milkshake.
No problem. Change seats.
Good idea.
You gotta jump on the telephone, call up a friend. Don't stop talking till 10:30. Back to the kitchen, old ice box. Cool lemonade and a warm ham hock. She's a milkshake, a mademoiselle. Cool as she can be. She's a milkshake, a mademoiselle. Look at her, what she doing to me? Look at her!
Hey, I see you're with a new girl.
It's not new. She's been around for a while.
What happened to that dumb blonde you used to go with?
I dyed my hair.
I thought blondes had more fun.
Not when they're with him.
Yeah.
Well, she turned on the TV. Go, girl, go. Sad love scene on the Late Late Show. She dream of tomorrow at recess time. She break another heart with the same old line. She's a milkshake, a mademoiselle. Cool as she can be. She's a milkshake, a mademoiselle. Look here, what you doing to me? Look at here, what you doing to me? Don't you stop, don't you doing to me? Oh, honey, what you doing to me?
Hey, kids, do me a favor.
What is it?
Please, make a circle. Come on, just make a circle. Get yourselves in a ring.
No, wait. Is this some kind of a trick?
It is for you. For other people, it's easy.
Okay, we're in a circle. Now what do you want?
Hello, police. I'd like to report a dope ring.
Go away.
that's our show for tonight. We want to thank James Darren. You did such a great job that all us guys got together and decided we definitely want you back on the show. The vote was 5-4 with one abstaining. And the little Mary McTavish of Jamestown, New York, who wrote in asking for a lock of my hair. I am happy to report that locks of my hair will soon be available in stores throughout the country. They'll be selling at $1.98 a barrel. In closing, I'd like to recite a poem written by the great Robert Browning when he was only 8 years old. I quote, I see London, I see France. Well, we're a little late. You can finish it yourself. Good night, Grease Bookies.
Or write veterans.
You got it. Check it out.
I got $5 that says I can put the 8 ball in the right-hand corner pocket with my eyes shut.
Oh,
yeah? Well, you got a bet. Okay. Hey. Now I understand why they call him Crooked Fats.
I bet you can't do that again.
Hey, you want to bet on last year's World Series?
Trio! Now, here they are, all greased up and ready to sing their brains out. Yeah, nah, nah.
1, 2, 3. Yeah. 1, 2, 3. Yeah. Ah. All right. Yeah. You got to know how to pony.
Last one unrolled my pants. Good night, everybody, and grease for peace. Well, see, if you're wondering why I'm saying good night here at the beginning of the show, it's because our research indicates that a lot of yous don't stick around long enough to see the end of the show. And that includes several guys in Sha Na Na. Anyways, for those of yous who don't plan to stick around for the end of the show, the joke's on you, because you already did. Gotcha. And now, on with the show.
Greasers Hall Settlement House. Yes, I'm Armand Fussy, the director in residence. Who's calling?
The White House? Oh, the president thinks they're the greatest singing group around today, and he wants them to sing at a state dinner? And he's going to give them an award for excellence? Wow. Okay, I'll tell him. Hey, you guys, if you see the Kingston Trio, tell him I got a message for him.
I'd give a lot of dough if only I could know the answer to my question. Is it yes or is it no? Does your chewing gum lose its flavor on the bedpost overnight? If your mother says don't chew it, do you swallow it in spite? Can you catch it on your tonsils? Can you heave it left and right? Does your chewing gum lose its flavor on the bedpost overnight? Here comes the blushing bride. The groom is by her side. Up to the altar, it's as steady as Gibraltar. Now the groom has got the ring, and it's such a pretty thing. But as he slips it on her finger, the choir begins to sing. Does your chewing gum lose its flavor on the bedpost overnight? If your mother says don't chew it, do you swallow it in spite? Can you catch it on your tonsils? Can you heave it left and right? Does your chewing gum lose its flavor on the bedpost overnight? Now the nation rose as one to send their honored son up to the White House, yes, the nation's only White House, to voice their discontent. Up to the president, they asked this burning question, what has swept this continent? If tin whistles is made of tin, what do they make foghorns out of? Does your chewing gum lose its flavor on the bedpost overnight? If your mother says don't chew, do you swallow it in spite? Can you catch it on your tonsils? Can you heave it left and right? Does your chewing gum lose its flavor on the bedpost overnight? On the bedpost overnight.
I thought of that. I loved you, and I want to hold you tight.
A Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday night on the bedpost over.
A dollar is a dollar, and a dime is a dime.
I'd sing another chorus, but I haven't got time. On the head.
Like a great big sirloin steak, medium rare, smother it with onions, and a baked potato with sour cream and chives.
Oh, well, what kind of wine would you like with that?
You don't serve wine here.
Yeah, well, we don't serve that other stuff here neither. But I figured if you was dreaming, you might like some wine to go with it.
Chance. Oh, come on, lady. Give us a break. It's the only way we could get the Kingston Trio on the show.
But why the costumes and the chanting?
Oh, this is a ruse to get the Kingston Trio with the singer on our show, so we're pretending to be flower children, man. Wow.
Flower children? You look more like blooming idiots to me.
What are we...
Fellas, fellas, I just telephoned the Kingston Trio. I informed them that I was the dean of a major high-class university.
Right.
And further, I told them that a group of fanatic hippies were threatening to take over our campus unless they came over. And they said they were on their way.
Oh, wow! Far out! Out of sight!
Groovy!
I think I see him coming now!
The Kingston Trio is here.
That ain't the Kingston Trio. There's only three guys.
Wait a minute, Dean Denny. These aren't college kids.
Of course they are. This is a barber college.
Yeah.
This is Harvard University.
I think we're dealing with some kindergarten dropouts here.
Yeah, this could only be, this would only be one group. This is Sha-na-na.
Oh, no. School's out, boys.
Hold it, folk breath.
Who are you?
I'm the student body, and speaking for the student body,
you don't sing, you could wind up with a degree in dead.
Yeah.
What do we want to do?
We want to sing. When do we do it?
Now.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, three very, very smart people who stopped us from taking over the campus and always are at the head of their class, the Kingston Trio.
Let me tell you a story about a man named Charlie on that tragic and fateful day. He put the tins in his pocket, this is why he landed right on the MTA.
Well, he has returned, no, he never returned, and his fate is still unlearned. He may rise to every street above, but he's a man who never returned.
Charlie handed in his dime at the Kendall Square station and he changed for Jamaica Plain. When he got there, the conductor told him one more nickel Charlie could get off of that train.
And he returned, so he never returned, and his fate is still unlearned. He may ride to the streets of Boston, he's a man who never returned.
Charlie's wife goes down to the Sky Square station at Brickell at 2:15. And through the open window she and Charlie sandwich as the train goes rumbling through.
Has he ever returned? Oh, he never returned. And the train is still unlearned. He may ride to death. He's a man who never returned. He's a man who never returned.
Priscilla, I come bearing another message of love from my good friend, John Alden.
What saith he this time, Miles Standish?
He beseecheth me to tell yous. Where do I begin it? To tell the story of how great a love can be it. The sweet love story that is older than the sea. Where do I start it? Well, what are you thinking?
I diggeth the lyrics, but why don't you speak at them for yourself, John?
I love you, Priscilla!
All right. You made your point, John.
Baby, you know I do. But I've got to see this book of love, find out why it's true.
Well, wonder, wonder,
who wrote the book of love?
Roxanne, Roxanne, you must know that I've loved you ever since we were children.
Yes, Bruno, I know, I know. But you know, our love can never be.
But why? You must tell me, Roxy, is it my nose?
Bruno, Bruno, you're such a fool. Of course it's your nose.
Why didn't you say so?
You know something?
It wasn't your nose.
Well, thank you very much.
You love her with all your heart. Chapter 2, you tell her you're never, 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 ever gonna part. In Chapter 3, remember the meaning of romance. In Chapter 4, you break up, but you give her just one more chance.
Oh, I wonder, wonder, whom, ba-doo-doo,
who wrote the book of love?
A toast to us, the two greatest lovers in the world.
To us, me, Don Juan, and yous, Casanova.
Yes, Don, between the two of us, I've guessed we've romanced just about every broad in Europe.
I guess there's nothing we don't know about the fine art of romance.
Right, for example, there are 74 ways that yous can kiss a woman.
Right.
One, on the lips.
Good Lord! 75.
Baby, 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 I love you, yes I do. But it said so in this book of love, ours is the one that's true.
Well, wonder, wonder, whom, ba-doo-doo,
who wrote the book of love? I wonder who,
yeah,
who wrote the book of love?
Who told you I was easy?
Nobody.
Don't give me that. Who told you?
Well, all right. George Thomas, Billy Burton, Vinnie DeTaylor, Marvin E. Elder, the Pilkowski twins, Sir Melvin Fraser, Crazy Howard, Mr. Epstein, Cubby Murphy, Jimmy the Slob, Big John, Little John, and John.
You believe John?
First of all, closer to the aisle. You may start with a simple conversation, like, darling, please put me on trial. She says, yes, and your heart starts beating, while each step draws you closer to the aisle. You ask her if she loves you. She answers, I do. Your heart starts glowing inside. And then you will know she is just for you. While each step draws you closer to the aisle. Then you put a ring on her finger, and a tear starts flowing in a while. Then you'll know she's yours forever. While each step draws you closer to the aisle.